Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Connor. I am here with my father,
Kevin.
And today we are doing an album from Logic, Under Pressure. This is his debut album, debut studio album. We have some history with Logic that we can go into a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Logic was one of the first rappers I kind of got into, not the first, but one of the first. The first being Mac Miller and Kid Cudi, but Logic was in the early stages of when I was getting into music. And I remember when Under Pressure released, I was very excited. So I went to go see his tour, but I was young and I didn't want to go by myself. So I dragged you along.
Yeah.
And that was your first hip hop show.
Yes.
And we got to meet Logic, which was fun.
And Big Lenbo.
Anyway. Yeah. So this album to me, you know, people are probably going to wonder, you know, why'd you choose to do this album today? Just because, you know, there's a lot of hip hop albums out there that we still haven't got to. We haven't even touched Jay-Z or Outkast or any old school hip hop, and we still got Kanye and all that. But
so why are you doing this album?
Yeah, well, the reason is, I listened to this album a lot when I was younger, and when it came out, and I really enjoyed it. Yeah, we'll get into this record. It touches on kind of where he was at this time in his life. This was right when he signed a record deal. And he was kind of this underdog story mm-hmm. of this guy who was releasing mixtapes in the underground for years and finally getting his chance to show the world who he is and tell his story.
Okay.
So it is a pretty cool album in that sense, and some really great production. So track number one, intro.
I just wanna make these music lovers remember again. While the haters fall back like September again. I was hoping three stacks and big would assemble again. Drop the politics and bring us together again. Maybe if I go platinum, they'll remember me then. But I'm not defined by the sales of my first week. Cause in my mind, the only way I fail if my verse weak. As I look in the crowd, I see thousands of different faces. Compile the different races, gathering from different places. Feeling like my dream is a world away.
This is solid, man.
Yeah.
Wow.
I don't know how, but I'ma find a way. Searching for the sun in a world of gray. I used to wonder what it feel like. Yeah. Used to wonder what it. I used to wonder what it feel like.
Now, oh, wicked.
To the Under Pressure program.
I expected to come out and it was just going to be
spitting bars,
really fast spitting bars, like he's done, right?
Yeah,
but that's I tell you right now, and just right off of this, I don't know, you got to do the math on me on these kind of things, but I can hear his influence in chords.
Oh, Mac Miller,
yeah.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. Yeah, he's Logic was some of his biggest inspirations. Mac Miller, J. Cole, Kendrick.
Yeah, Drake. No, I can hear the chording in that and some of the phrasing and stuff like that. And wow, it's I wasn't surprising. I thought this was going to be really fast. But anybody, really?
Yeah, no.
There's going to be some of that though. I'm presuming.
Oh yeah, yeah.
There'll be some fast.
You can expect that in the Logic project. Track number two, Soul Food.
Conversations with legends. Crazy how one day your idols can turn into your brethren. Bitches, we
his errand. Hit up my jeweler, watch him freeze. It's chillin', sippin' Sinatra from a flask. Lil' Bobby, just a youngin'. Skatin' was my hobby, trying to stay out of trouble. My homie in jail, Ferrari welfare. Food stamps and stealing from the stove. Come home and see an eviction notice take to my dough. Racism, the illest. My chain is the chillest, sub-zero. Far from a hero, bitch, I'm the Nero.
Fuck, I love when the kit came back in it.
Me, that's bring an umbrella. Let me tap into my inner southern killing another illa. Murdered the game and it resurrected like Thriller. Dilla does.
Oh, some great sounds going here, eh?
Really great production.
Yeah,
on this
wow. Ooh.
I swear this music in my jeans like denim. Lyricism, see venom like venom. Yes, I know the flow hotter than Lucifer, even though heaven sent him. See my vision as I've elevated and risen. Open your eyes, despise lies, come with deadly precision. Making a killing, feel my energy. I ain't talking E-N-E-I-G-Y, I mean energy. That's the shit they never see, but I own supremacy. Number one, I better be. Bitch, I said I bet I be. Take my kindness for weakness, trying to get the better of me. Cause they want what they want, how they want, when they want it. I just gave them 20 songs, now they want it. Another 100, I just see it as a challenge. I can do it, bitch, I run it. Worldwide tours, type of shit I always wanted. While the rest of them just worry about bitches and getting blunt. My jeans like denim, lyricism seeping them like venom. Yes, I know the flow hotter than Lucifer, even though heaven sent them. Spit it like holy water, prophetically repent them. There we go.
Okay, that was some serious spitting.
Yeah, that's the spitting that you didn't hear on that intro track.
Yeah, that's wow. I'm excited for the rest of the tracks now because it's the first one really didn't give me much of an indication of what's coming on. But I tell you though, I hear the influences.
Yes, from other artists.
I
sure.
really, really hear the influences. I hear some bit of Kendrick in there. When he threw in Popo and stuff like that, maybe that's just a word that they use, but that for me was like...
Yeah, Kendrick uses that word a lot.
Yeah, right. Yeah. So I was like, okay, there's some Kendrick in here. I heard some... we just said...
Cole,
J. Cole.
Yeah.
I can hear J. Cole in there. So it's... For me, it's I'm interested to get through the rest of these to see how... he establishes himself to my ear as himself.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Right? Because I hear other people already. Like I hear Mac at the beginning. I hear it. So I'm just
curious to see how
he comes
into his own.
Yeah. If Logic comes out to his own in this album. Right. So,
mm-hmm, yeah. Track number three, I'm Gone.
Living life like this is so crazy.
So crazy.
This world is amazing.
Amazing.
One day you're on top and the next she having your baby. Living life like this, I get down. I'm gone. So long. I'm gone.
Sounds like you in the background.
Yeah, the deep voice.
With your deep.
So what now?
So what now?
Let's get down, let's get drowned. On this vision, my division is the greatest that's around. So long.
Some really interesting sounds in this, eh?
Yeah.
That sounds like
an ocean or something.
Yeah, it sounds like vocals that are put into a sample for a synth.
Cool. Exotic. I don't smoke, but she love to smoke and look good as fuck when she light it. When she ride it, it's crazy. Love when I get inside it. Baby, stop trying to hide it. Brown. I'm feeling you, feeling me. Know that you into me, baby girl. Let me get down, cause my mind gone.
When he starts going on the revving up the gas, eh?
Yeah.
Living life like this is so crazy.
So crazy.
This world is amazing. One day you're on top, and the next she having your baby. Living life like this, I get down.
This is where you come in. Drink, smoke, vibe, fuck, yeah. Chill, drive, talk.
I'm trying to do it.
Right?
Yeah.
Drink, smoke, vibe, fuck, chill,
drive,
talk. think about it. Drink, smoke,
you got
vibe,
it.
Fuck, smoke, vibe, think about it.
You got it. You killed it.
Making a single before your album is like putting together a trailer for a movie you have yet to shoot.
Making a single before your album is like putting together a trailer for a movie you have to shoot. Oh, okay, okay, okay. Yeah. I got that. That was a really good track as well, man. Production was great. The sounds on this, I have to say though,
when he picks up?
When he picks up and he said,
the percussiveness.
The percussiveness, it's really cool, right?
Yeah.
Like, I'm waiting for him to get really going and roll. And Tally, are they trying to make her sound somewhat computer generated?
Yeah, computer, okay. Like Skippy and computer.
Skippy and that. Okay, yeah, yeah.
It actually takes influence from this record there, Midnight Marauders. Which we will do at some point. They have the same concept, so he kind of put that into his
own. Oh, really?
He did a spin of that on his own record, which I think was kind of cool.
Oh, wow.
Track number 4, Gang Related.
Oh, some cool sounds, man.
Yeah.
I might take that just for my meditations.
I don't know if this is a meditation song, though.
Yeah. Yeah. Living life like this. Gotta paint a picture when I write like this. Born and raised in my area. Beautiful by day, by night. It's hysteria. Fuck around and bury it at night. Ride it with my homies on site. Mama tell me to come in at night. Now I really gotta go, but they never know. Living life to the fullest, I gotta blow. Po-po, finna bust in the dough. We got blow in the crib, in the kitchen over there. Instead of the baby with the bib. Call the cops. Do it for the money and the bitches and the drugs and the props. Tell me why another body even gotta drop. Get shot off top for some shit that was gang related.
Up first at 5 tonight, breaking news in Gaithersburg, where a massive manhunt is underway after a deadly shooting. It's all unfolding in the 400 block of West Deer Park.
Stay strapped, but I hate it when I take it out. If you want it, I'ma lay it out. I'm a little brother, make it out. Every night, what I pray about, what I pray about, check it out. Yeah, got a son on the way, but I cling to the streets even though I wanna run away. I imagine a better life, why I never had a dead of life. Hit you with the in the dead of night. Selling crack to my own pops. Get down or lay down. Hit you with the Beretta, you better stay down. Straight shots on the playground. Living how I'm living with the life that I'm giving. Anybody that's riding with me, I'm riding with him. Show me the enemy and I'ma hit him. The second I bit him, I get him and hit him with the venom. Ain't no need to pretend I'ma never do it. I knew it, I've already been through it. I do it for the street, for the fam, for the life. Anybody that's gang related.
Holy shit.
Yeah, that part.
Man, I needed the lyrics in front of that, man. You know, I want to make one point right now before I love how there's two things happening here. You've got, it sounds like monks chanting out in the forest somewhere.
Yeah, you, the sample.
And then you've got that.
The gang violence.
And then you've got that gang violence and you've got those two things going on. They're sort of just interplaying with each other. It's so... Mm-hmm. It's cool. It's really
eerie.
It's eerie. It's eerie. Yeah. Like, through the song, I feel peace from hearing that. But then the words you're reading are just totally non-peace.
Yeah.
Completely the opposite, right?
Yeah. Track number 5, Buried Alive.
Tell me how you feel.
Tell me how you feel.
I feel like the grass is green, and everything I do is unseen.
I really hear
but
Mac.
I know that's just in my mind. I know everything is just in my mind. Do you really want to be famous? Do you really want to be a superstar? Do you really want to get dangerous? Everything happens for a reason. People only end your life for seasons. Word to Aunt Viv. Death and taxes, that's all we're giving. You can make a life, but can't make a living. You can make it work, but that still ain't driven. Give a lot, but that still ain't giving. Living life like this ain't real, though. Man, everybody want this shit for free. Hand out, palm up when they get to me. In my mind, no, I never let it get to me. Everybody got a turn when they get to me. V's up, motherfucker, that's victory. Tell me why what I'm doing ain't shit to me. Damn.
Buried alive.
Buried alive.
Will I survive?
Man, the production on this song, this album is fucking really good. It's getting stronger progressively.
I think it's my favorite Logic album, production-wise,
yeah,
for sure.
They never debated
thinking I made up my mind, jaded, no one ever evaded. I elevated just to keep it innovative. Innovative, goddamn, bring it back now. Blowing up like a rap now. Rap back, put me on the map now. No, we never back down. Just take my time, I just take my time. I know, I'ma get it like this. So everyone know that I did it like this. Yeah, I know, I'ma take my time.
Oh, yeah. This might be my favorite track so far.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I love everything about it.
It goes through so many different phases.
I know. But
it's all seamless.
Yeah, it's well done. Nice beat. This is my favorite track here. Everything about it was good, man. It was just the flow and just the lyrics and the bass and the drum beat right off the bat, the changes, the way they all seamlessly came in. This is a good one. Do you like this track?
Yeah. Oh yeah. One of my favorites for sure. Yeah. There's a few that I have on here that are some of my favorites.
I love do you really want to be famous? Do you really want to be a superstar? Do you really want to get dangerous? And then there's a push in that.
Yeah.
Just in there, just to push those three lines, and then it just drops, and then it drops back down again. Cool, man. This is a cool track. I think this album for me is getting stronger. I probably said that 3,000 times
as it goes on.
Yeah, it's getting better.
Yeah,
it's getting better.
Track number 6, Bounce.
Living good, I've been living good, rolling through my hood, understood, just a youngin' in this bitch up to no good, in the whip, every day with Nikki, she be riding with me, never trip, and away without a flex, psych, take a trip, little trip, life is what you make of it, I've been focused on this music, can't fuck with no basic bitch, let me switch the flow up a little bit, if you really bout it, but I doubt it, yes I do, seem like all this new shit really just left over residue, I'm coming through, if I see your bitch, I bet she coming too. We ain't never switch it up, we keep it true. Out the blue, like a crib, never left. Had to take a breath, cause Nikki been fucking with me hardcore. God damn, that's my fucking jam. They know who I am, bitch, bounce. Homie, smoke an ounce, fuck it, make it count real. I know, I got it, I want it, I need it. We live in an era where they get deleted. I'm wondering if I'ma make it, man, fuck it, I take it. That record, I break it, these bitches, they love it. But I never covet, I just keep it going. That's why I be flowing, I'm already knowing. It's like that I'm living, don't know what I'm giving. It's so hard not to give in.
Oh, shit. It's like being in a car at 40 and then just going, yeah. Okay, I'll do this right.
Locations where the album were recorded include.
Locations where the album was recorded include.
I'm still not feeling.
I'm
not feeling her doing that. Look, where. Great track, great, fantastic track. I just found the chorus fucking way too much for me.
Yeah, this funny enough, this track, I remember Logic talking about how this one was made really only for the live shows. Like he wanted to have one that can really just get people fucking going.
Yeah.
I think this is my least favorite off the album for sure.
When he's the pre-chorus and the chorus in this, pre-chorus and the verses in this I liked, and then when we hit the chorus, it was in the cans. It was fucking way too much. I'd love to hear some more separation in there, but it was just like, oh my god, I was trying to read the lyrics and decipher where they're going. There's boom, and there's a lot of stuff going on.
I think he went with this track just a little, like the one thing that turns me off of it is just he went a little too overboard with the bunch of the callbacks and stuff. Like you got like 8 different voices going on during the bounce.
I'm glad you heard them, because I thought it was just me.
No, yeah.
I need my meds.
Track number 7, which is titled Growing Pains 3.
So was there 2 more?
There was,
okay.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Talking is wild. You gotta stay low with her, man.
It was cool. I, you know, nigga got crazy, so I had to lay him out.
You get crazy.
Yeah, outside I can hear them bussing, and the police they rushing. Go to my head like concussion. I'd rather not have this discussion. My mind racing from the elevation of the toxic in my blood. Where my mind don't know now, but I know where it was. I need Nikki. Where is Nikki? Baby girl, please come and get me. Now I'm older, shit is trippy, but I know that God is with me. Section 8, grab a plate, food for thought, gravitate, food stamp. Social services trying to take me away. My mama locked up. I pray to God that I see her today. Maybe not, maybe so. Westdale Park, that's all I know. Just me and my homies, people that know me, only ones that know. Around my way, living day by day, living day by day. Four rows and hang time. What to do? What would you? When will I lose my anonymity and become one with the enemy? Tell me, would that be the enemy? Feel like nobody in front of me. I could feel the vibe.
He's a drummer, man.
Yeah,
like
that whole verse is just fucking going.
It's crazy, and you know what? I lost the lyrics because it doesn't work. I can hear them. My dreams fade. Everything cascade in this vanilla sky. I feel like David Ames. Why must I open my eyes? On the TV, let it wash my brain. Pretend that family's my family to avoid the pain. Hello, children. How was school?
It was good. How about you? I love you. I love you. I love mama too. Are you ready for dinner? I'm able to set the table till I snap out the fable. When that TV turned off and I realize I'm back in hell.
That song is no fucking around. Right?
Not at all.
Not at all. It was just...
Right from the start.
Right from the start, right to the... Just before Talia... It was totally...
Talia comes in.
And... Totally, it's totally, totally strong. And you know what? I lost the lyrics on this thing because of Genius. Thanks, Genius. I lost them all, but I listened with my... Closed my eyes and I got all the lyrics, like, which is super cool.
Mm.
Even at his fast pace when he started going.
Yeah. No, it's not too hard to pick up with that track.
Yeah.
And...
great sounds, man.
Yeah, no, I don't know if it's if it was completely Logic, because I know Logic does production, but I don't know if it was him or if Six, his producer, did a lot of work on this as well, or who picked what samples and what sounds, but they did a fantastic job at creating atmospheric songs for each one.
You hit the word atmospheric. Like, really, yeah. Really. It's got from the monks chanting, and then the earlier track where it sounded like a vocal pad of a sample of somebody's, of female vocalists, and all those, that feeling, man, that atmosphere, right?
Yeah. Track number 8, Never Enough.
When that liquor get pour up, and that green get roll up. When them sets get throwed up, I'm like, nah, man, hold up. Yeah, we bout to show enough. But I hope they don't call my bluff, cause my mind is going crazy. This shit is never enough. When that liquor get pour up,
oh yeah, fuck yeah.
When them sets get throwed up, I'm just going crazy.
My god, that's interesting. Having that extra snare beat in there.
Never enough. Never enough. Never enough. This shit is never enough. Never enough. Crush a bit, little bit, roll it up, take a hit at the party.
You know where that's from, right?
Yeah.
Walk up and they play my shit on the road, kick a soul.
Do you have to pay for that?
Sell my soul.
Sample there.
Oh, yeah.
Domination is the goal. Where you stay every day, just got my crib in LA. We are the coolest motherfuckers on the planet. Drop that new shit just cause they demand it.
Yeah, yeah.
Living like we got it cause we get it.
Yeah, yeah.
I love those horns right there. Now we dropped that.
Never enough. This shit is never enough.
Oh, hear that sweep?
Yeah.
The majority of the album was recorded in only 2 weeks.
I don't know.
That one's an okay fact. It's interesting.
No, no, no. It's great. It's just that I know now at the end of the track that she's coming, and I'd like to just stop it so I don't hear her.
I don't think she's...
Yeah.
I think she might be done soon.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. No, the fucking track was musically hot. It was great. The drums were... Everything was great. then I have a break, and I'm like, okay, just... Can we just go into the next track?
Yeah, instead. Logic used the bathroom 4 times while making this song.
Because he had some burritos.
From Taco Bell.
No, I'm not shitting. I'm just... It doesn't work.
Yeah, no.
I think it would be wicked if she just... I know it's going back to the homage to something else, but if she would have just... Would she just spoke it? Like, really nice?
Yeah.
The album was created over the span of 1 year. However, the majority of the album was recorded in only 2 weeks.
Yeah, no. Like I said earlier, it worked for Tribe because... It's the lo-fi 90s feel, but this has a modern feel. So having that skippy,
you know,
robotic
voice, what
the fuck is this?
Yeah, but it would be cool. Like I said, if it was more modern and she said it, you know.
In a sexy voice.
ASMR. Yeah, not even have to be sexy. Just like break it up and do it like, you know, this album was created over, you know.
Yeah.
That type of thing.
But anyway, you like the track overall.
I like the track overall, yeah. And
people know that. You're not bullshitting when you say you're a Cuddy fan because
right away I'm like, did he pay Cuddy or what?
Yeah, well, they're cool. I think Cuddy took him on tour when he was on his come up.
Oh, did he?
He's like one of his biggest inspirations. Logic's,
yeah.
Cuddy is Logic's one of his biggest inspirations. So,
oh, cool. You really do hear a lot of influence on the stuff though, right?
Yeah.
But you know what? It's you. We talked about earlier, and he's come into his own as I'm hearing this thing. Like at the beginning,
the more
like,
it progresses,
the more it progresses, you're starting to hear his thing and know more of his personality and get where he's coming from. I didn't know where he was from and in the backstory with his brother and all that kind of stuff. And you start to learn that and then you have a likability about that and you start to know and put all those factors together and you're making your own, you know, your own thing in your head about how you're going to interpret the music, right?
Mm. Track number 9. It is titled Metropolis.
Oh, yeah, see?
It's already catchy.
Fucking Stuart Copeland on the drums right there.
Sometimes I feel like I've drifted. I feel different. I feel gifted. I've been high so long. Don't need to smoke to get lifted. I've been under pressure looking for Nikki. Whenever she is around, you know I come quickly. Vivid memories of Chicago. South side where I go. Yeah. And I know that ain't nobody finna ever be ahead of me. Y'all that competition right there dead of me. Yeah. Yeah. I've been turning the pages. Feeling the vibe. Shit is outrageous. Boy, I've been feeling courageous. This shit right here, I've been at it for ages. Feel like I'm running through mazes. Living on the road to success, and you know that I'm driven. But it ended when I publish it.
Yeah,
right,
see,
now,
Connor,
that, shit. I'm in a different world. I'm with a different girl. I'm with the same team, but it's a different scheme. Remember back when I couldn't even pay the bills. And I never forget how that feels. Back when I went by it, break it, roll it, light it, smoke it, inhale it. I'm gone. Buy it, break it, roll it, light it, smoke it, inhale it. I'm gone. Okay, doing what I gotta do, flying at this altitude. I look out the window like goddamn, that's what I really do. Hotel in Belgium, Dan and Waffles was insane. Smoking blunts in Amsterdam, oh my god, this is my jam. May to December, but most deaf in my headphones, that's the man. I know that I got it if I
him?
Do what I gotta do to get by. And they wonder why I never get high. Wonder why I never get high.
I know.
Like this girl, she bad as fuck, why must I run away? You feel like self-assassination, I can't put this gun away. Goddamn, what's the plan? Not complacent where I am.
Wow, that was great right there, man.
I hit the road back in that minivan. Broke as fuck, not a dollar. Whipping that Chevy Impala. Praying that we make it out the city. Lord willing, inshallah. Up to date a couple years. Now my idols are my peers.
Oh my god, have you seen Pulp Fiction?
Yeah, but I don't remember it.
What are you talking about? Have you seen, it's just funny because we're on a train. Have you seen, fuck. What's his name?
Oh, you know what? I could hear Yusuf Days, the guy who loved the drum. I could hear him killing it with this.
The original?
Oh, thank you.
I'll cut it off.
The original members of the rap pack include C. Dot Castro, Big Lenbo, and Logic.
Yeah.
I sounded like the guy with the...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and Logic.
Anyway, you like that track?
I love that track. just as we're talking about drums and that mix with the flow, boom, it comes in. Boom. Man, I don't... I would love to see him perform something like this with like a guy like
Tiny Desk on
a Tiny Desk with like yeah, just a couple guy bass keys.
What's his name? The guy I forget his name. You just mentioned him.
Tom Misch and no, Yusuf Days.
Is he the one from Daft Punk album?
Oh no, that's Omar Hakim.
Oh yeah,
Yusuf Days is with Tom Misch, and remember
yes, you played me that. That was fantastic.
Yeah, he's insane, right? And so I could hear him just killing that. I would have trouble just keeping that beat because I would like to just offbeat cymbal shots. I
do some different shit.
A China crash and caca and caca.
Fucking throw the sticks in the air.
Yeah, can you? Hey. Out of here.
Yeah. Get Let someone me sing else. It. Track number 10.
Oh, okay. I was going to ask you this question now.
What?
Who is Nikki?
Oh, yeah. He talks about Nikki.
This is it. Now it looks like. Okay. Let's go.
Okay.
I can feel you in my lungs, feel you in my veins. Bloodstream, only way to make it to my brain. Nikki, baby, I love you, but now I gotta go. Cause in the end what happens you already know. Probably wonder where I've been at, I've been laying low. But in my mind I'm wondering what I'm paying for. All these other bitches on my dick but I can't fuck with that. That's what I thought at first, me and you together, swear to God it's hard at work. Away from you though man, it's just so hard to work. My heart is hard at work, we've been together like 10 years. Goddamn, took me as a young man. What would they write up on my grave? A free man,
this is
an
unreal way to talk about it, eh?
Yeah.
Crazy.
Nothing, no. Oh no, I can't fade that shit, I gotta let you go. You got me tripping like a flight to Vegas. All the shit you got me doing, man, it's outrageous. I hate it that I need you, Nikki. But I love it when I feed you, Nikki. I hate that I bleed for you. I long and I need for you. But I love it when I taste you. But lately I've been feeling like a slave for the nicotine. Slave for the... Said I'm a slave for the nicotine. Been a slave for you. I'm a motherfucking slave for you. Slave for the nicotine. Nikki. Nikki. Slave for you. I'm a slave for you, Nikki.
Okay, now I gotta go back in the other songs and look at the Nikki references now.
Yeah, he references a lot.
It's in there a lot.
Yeah.
Wow, that what an interesting perspective of this, yeah?
Yeah.
Thank you. Sorry. Thalia?
Thalia, yeah.
Thalia, we cut you off. All the handwriting on the album's artwork was done by Big Lenbo. Okay. What an interesting way to put that.
Yeah. No, I remember first listen for me, it was kind of cool because I automatically assumed he's talking about a girl.
Yeah.
Because you don't think too much. But then you look back, like on the song Metropolis, he's like, as soon as I get off the plane, Nikki, where I need Nikki or whatever.
Oh,
like,
my
so,
God.
So I'm thinking it's a girl. Like he gets off a plane, he's got to see this girl. But no, he's on a plane for sick, going to Europe and he needs his nicotine.
Ah, see, okay. Because I know Jess, right?
His ex-wife.
His ex-wife, yeah. Right? He was with her at the time, right?
Yeah.
So that's what I was confused with this because I was thinking, who's Nikki now?
Yeah, there's another girl.
I'm like, I thought he's not saying anything about Jess, and then he's talking about Nikki. I'm like, where's Nikki? So now we get to this one. I knew who Nikki is.
Yeah. Okay. No, it's just a reference for nicotine. Which
okay.
It's kind of cool. I like the concept of it. Track number 11, Under Pressure.
Holy shit.
A flashback of a youngin' sippin' that purple Kool-Aid. Skipping school with my homies and chief and reefer for 2 days. Running from the law, living how I'm living, fuck 'em all. Bumping 666, Hennessy in my cup, driving through the sticks. Who the bitch riding with me, man?
Oh, nice drop.
Trying to get me by it, break it, roll it, light it, smoke it, inhale it, write it, record it, mix it, master it, press it up, unveil it. Feel like
I've been waiting
forever to inherit. This is war. I declare it, time is money, I can't spare it. Futuristic, so simplistic. Please decipher my linguistics, slow it down, roll it, tussin'. I'm the king, ain't no discussion. And now we blowing up like spontaneous human combustion. We're so fucking
fuck,
much.
That was great.
Yeah, that was great.
Every diamond in my chain, yeah, that's a milestone.
people calling me, asking me for money, man. The only thing I'ma give you motherfuckers is a dial sign. Goddamn, goddamn, we at it again. Me and my homies that know me, blowing up like the Taliban. I'm living divine, you know that I'm one of a kind, let me get it right now. Ho, kicked up and I'm dripped out, and I'm dripped out right now. Ho, kicked up till I cash out, now got all my wondering how. So, on the down low, haters drown slow. On the down low, haters drown slow.
Oh, that was cool,
oh,
man.
God, my God, we got it all right. Oh God, my God, we gotta get it right. We make a story positive, that life ain't mine, bitch, you can take that shit to more. Work so fucking much, my greatest fear is I'ma die alone. Every diamond in my chain, yeah, that's a milestone.
Hello, no one is available to take your call.
I've been working hard, I've been searching for God. Little brother, this is your sister. You're busy, I get you, but I insist you call me back, cause I miss you. I wish you well, well, I wish you would call. Cause lately you feel like I'm just not your sister at all. Always seem to pick up the phone and somehow I feel better. But you've been answering me lesser and lesser, so I've resorted to the pills on my dresser. I'm gone. And as for Drake, oh no, he left and he ain't coming back. Hey son, this is your father, don't mean to bother. How are you? Heard you were in town, but I never saw you. Tried to call you, where are you? In Paris? What a beautiful destination to perish, right by the Eiffel. Come now, please don't be spiteful of all my small talk. I think we're overdue a long talk. I love you, I swear. Bobby, I know you're there. And when the time is right, I know that you gon' take care of anything I need, of your family. Can I have some tickets to your next show? Will you stand with me? Can I have some money for my new honey? That's hella fine. I forgot to mention I got divorced from your stepmom. My mom.
Barry, what's up, bro? I ain't want much, man. Just calling, seeing what's going on. I know you're busy. Nigga, hit me.
Dear family, I'm so sorry that I've been distant. Everything changed in an instant. My time has been inconsistent. I know that you've been insistent. I know that birthday I missed it. I swore I told my assistant, but I guess my mind is in another place. Thoughts off in another world. I started seeing another girl. It fell through, man, what a world. Meanwhile, people outside of my blood asking for favors. I don't owe you a fucking thing. You best switch your behavior. Truly remarkable how I barely know you, but somehow owe you when you don't even know about the shit I go through. We ain't spoken in a while. Tell me, sister, how your child? Come now, girl, give me a smile. Come on, girl, don't do me fat. Everything I love, everything I need. Never sacrifice this feeling, even though my heart bleed. Under pressure. I've been feeling under pressure.
And then I got to kill ya. I love you, son.
Wow. I am emotionally drained from that.
Yeah, that is a song and a half.
That's a more than that, man. It's crazy. Like, I'm just trying to, like, listening to it, and then and these interludes that
the
come in.
The voicemails.
The voicemails are just like, man, I'm confused, and I'm not logic. You know what I mean? Mm. Like, I'm confused with, like, what people calling and, you know what I mean? And just all the shit going on. It's
with family.
With and family, like, and the chaos and that, man.
Yeah. No, like, it's...
Is it a different logic than I...
That you thought?
Than I thought, yeah. Because, yeah, I thought, you know... I really thought he came from this other... This little
other
bit of
side of...
You know, just a more like a upper middle class type of thing, and everything
sheltered
and everything was okay.
Yeah.
And that's not what I'm seeing in this album at all.
Not at all. No. Yeah.
No.
I think newer fans might have that misconception just because if they don't go back and, you know, read into his older discography or his interviews. But
yeah,
two parts to that track. First part, very aggressive, talking about worrying about, you know, losing it all and stuff like that, and
yeah,
how he's worked so hard to get at this point, and then that beat change, and it's, you know, rapping from the perspective of his sister first, and
that was his sister, okay, yeah,
sister, and then his dad, I believe,
yeah,
and then
was his brother in there? I thought it was
the second voicemail was his dad. I guess maybe the first voicemail must have been his brother. I'm not sure, but
you know what? This I couldn't like. This is where I give kudos to these writers that that write all this down, that stuff that happened to them, like to actually put pen to paper and then write it down, like, and do, okay, first rhyme it and fucking make it sound great, but also let all that shit out of your soul and your heart and to put it down.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And to really, really, like, it you have to, because you have to go get that.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'm just thinking, like, you know, not mentioning anything personal, but, like, yeah, you know, you've had a lot of struggles in your,
yeah,
younger years and growing up. Do you think you could, like, you know, mentally dig deep back into those younger days where, you know, all that shit was going on? And
You know what? I think I could write amazing songs if I went to those. And I've spoken this before, is what I do is that I skim over the surface.
Mm-hmm.
And I just grab certain things that really aren't, they're not really deep. I'm not going deep into the dark fucking abyss.
Yeah.
So I'm skimming some stuff off the top, but I think if I really dove deep and then put those lyrics down to what, sometimes I do that when I'm ad-libbing. Mm-hmm. And I go and I ad-lib, and we're talking about that.
Yeah.
I close my eyes and if I'm with the band or I'm just ad-libbing and shit's coming out, and while it starts flowing, it's coming from some place and it's just coming out. And I think that's when you're starting to let it just release.
Mm-hmm.
And it comes out of those dark places, right? But I've never, that's why I admire these guys, these writers so much that put it down, because they have to go to that place. They have to deal with that thing.
Yeah.
And put it down. And then also they're performing it, recording it, and they're going back to that place all the time.
Well, and they're sharing it for
and
the
world.
And
they're sharing it for the world. And reliving it every time, does it make it easier? I don't know yet because I haven't done it. But to get it out of your system and to say it, maybe that's the healing process instead of holding everything in and not writing it.
Yeah. Yeah, I definitely think that's the case for some artists. I can't speak for Logic or for everybody, but I know for sure for some artists that is like it is a healing process, really. It's taking those dark parts of their life and putting it onto paper and vocalizing it.
Because being out in front of people, in front of that crowd, and actually and finally when it gets out of that place and then you're actually spitting it and it's coming out, it must feel like a release, you know.
Track number 12, Till the End.
It's the type of shit that they've read about. Like Chris said, I gotta bleed it out. I've been in the zone, I can't be without this real shit that I be about. I'm a visionary that's long term, but Def Jam said they needed that. If I rush the shit, I might be without, but I need a vision, can't see without. I've been patient, never complacent. Left the underground when I left the basement, that's renovation. I spit this verse like a revelation. On the road with Kid Cudi and B.I.G. Conversations with No I.D. Who made hits with Ye, got hits with Jay. I'm fact and I'm back again, cause I love the shit. Write it down and they publish it. I went 5 years without a publicist, cause a word of mouth, they in love with this. I've been dreaming, I've been scheming, went away a while, but I've been fiending. I miss the fan, but they know the deal. Been that away before the deal. Now the music got mass appeal, my main girl got ass appeal. Two about it when it comes to fucks, I get two about it. Yo, cosign, I could do without it.
Cool.
Great verse.
Great, great verse, man.
Last verse, I gotta make it count. Won't speak on my bank account. So many commas, I'd have to pause. And I can't afford to just waste the bars. Every day, boy, I thank the Lord. I got a lot of problems, but can have more. Wish I spoke to my dad more, my jeweler less. I've been hungry like Budapest. Tell me who the best. Don't give a fuck, I just know I'm blessed. It's radio, that's TV, but visionary got the internet. If y'all fuck around and try to throw the ball to another artist, I'ma intercept. It's my time. Put half a mil of my own money in this album. That's my dime. No rap features, just my rhymes. My story is all mine. From the basement to the stadium. Been a long round, so I gotta go. It's Logic, the one nobody would vouch for. How's that shit for an outro?
Right, that was fucking great, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, I remember something.
What?
From the show.
See?
Peace, love, and positivity.
Yes.
Didn't
he
say that all the time?
All the time.
Got people yelling it, right? This concludes the under pressure.
Nope. We're not done yet.
Oh.
See, it's good that I'm here to help you react to these albums, because you would have clicked. That was a good album, man.
includes the Under Pressure program.
That was a great track to end this on.
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad it didn't end on Under Pressure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It just that was lighter. It was cool. It's, you know what
more
I mean?
Motivating.
More motivating. Yeah, and it was cool to end on that.
I think this album would hold even more meaning to you if you followed Logic prior to this, like watching his come up through his mixtapes, because mm-hmm. it was such a natural progression. Like, just the fan base kept getting bigger and bigger, and people were doubting him, and it was kind of like a Kanye story, like a mini Kanye story.
Yeah,
people, you know, not taking him seriously and stuff, and
yeah,
just slowly building this really loyal fan base. And it was cool because by the time this album came out, everybody was like, who the fuck is this guy selling all these records, his debut yeah. record?
It's yeah.
like, we don't even fucking know who he is. Like, we just signed him to Def Jam.
Yeah.
And now he's fucking selling, like, I forget how many first week or whatever.
But yeah.
Everyone's like, what the fuck is this? It's because
he
built these years of this catalog of these mixtapes that people loved, yeah. and he grew this huge fan base in the underground.
I think he's great though. This is fantastic. This is really good, man.
Good body of work.
Yeah, really good, right? So I'll go back and I'll follow him again on Instagram.
You unfollowed him?
So. I think I unfollowed him when he retired. I did. When he retired.
That's when you unfollowed him.
Yeah, he said he was done.
Yeah, he's not done anymore.
Okay, so that's right. I did. It was when he retired, and I went, okay, he's done. So
yeah, no. So there's another album coming soon. Yeah. So I had a lot of fun today. I think we'll wrap the video up here. You had fun?
I had lots of fun. Yeah.
Thank you, guys. Do you have anything you want to say before we
close? I just want to say the same thing. Thank you very much, and love you all.
Yes, love you very much. Stay safe, everybody. Yeah. And we'll see you soon.